What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByteByte.com, and in this video, I want to talk about what you should tell your interviewer or what you should ask them when they tell you, do you have any questions? Right? Because this is something that comes up in basically every interview that you're going to do. You're going to go through the interview, and at the end, assuming that there's time left over, they're going to ask you if you have any questions for them. And this is a great opportunity for you to really connect with your interviewer and for you to really kind of seal the deal in your interview. Because depending on the types of questions you ask, you can actually really use this as a great opportunity to connect with the interviewer and leave them with a really strong impression of you. Because remember, first impression and last impression are the two most important things. We tend not to remember a lot of stuff that goes on in the middle of when we're like interacting with someone, but we remember that very initial impression that we had of them, and then we remember that very last thing they said. So like if you said something at the very end that rubbed your interviewer the wrong way, that is not a good thing, because they are definitely going to remember that when they are going to write a review of your interview, when they're going to decide whether to move you on to that next stage. And that's why this question is so important. And that's why it's so important that we come up with some good things to ask. So I want to give you three strategies that you can use here, three things to think about when you are thinking about what you're going to ask your interviewer. So the first thing to do is I recommend that you take some time to do research on the company. Because this is something, again, we've talked about this before, and as an interview hacker, this is a really important thing, is you want to go above and beyond what everyone else is doing. Everyone else is kind of doing the same old, and what you want to do is you want to be able to stand out. You want to be able to show that you're unique and different and that you're somehow better than the other candidates that they have. And so by doing in-depth research on the company and asking questions specifically about the company, that can make a huge difference. And so like an example of this might be, consider if you were interviewing at Amazon. I'm going to use this as an example because I think a lot of people are familiar with this. Amazon has their 12 leadership principles, right? And they really look for these as they're interviewing people. So something that you could think about when you are asking questions is you could ask them a question about these leadership principles. You could say, hey, I saw that leadership principle number 4 was X when I was researching Amazon, and that's something that's really important to me. So can you tell me about how you see that in the, you know, how you see people actually embodying that in their day to day? That would be a great question that you could ask because it's really specific. It's something they can answer, and it's something that they know that you spent a lot of time researching the company, right? And that you spent a lot of time and that you are more dedicated and you are more interested in this than their average candidate. Because the average candidate might just ask some very generic question about like, why is Amazon great? And then it's like, that's not a good question, right? And they kind of are going to brush that off. They're not going to think anything of it. But if you ask this really targeted specific question, it can show them that you are above and beyond the average candidate. The next thing that I want you to think about is asking questions that show very specific interest, right? Be careful when you're asking questions because you want to put yourself in the mind of your interviewer. Think about how you would feel if someone asked you this question, what the impression would be that you would get of the person if they asked you this question. So like, for example, consider the question, how many vacation days do you get? This is a very obvious answer or example of a question where that's going to show that you're not really that interested in the company, right? You're more interested in what's in it for me, how many vacation days do I get out of, how little do I have to work? The same might be true for questions that are not quite as direct. Like, do you guys allow people to work from home? What is your vacation policy? What is, questions about the salary, for example, at this stage. Obviously, you're going to ask some of these questions when you are speaking with your recruiter at the end of the day and you're negotiating that final offer, but that's very different than like when you're in an interview, when you're going through a technical interview. So think about how you can ask questions that are going to show interest rather than show lack of interest. So the flip side of this is like asking questions like the one that I just mentioned about the leadership principles and like how is this embodied in the company on a day-to-day basis. You might ask questions about specific projects or things that you're interested in, or tell them like, hey, you know, I've been working a lot on using React Native, and I'm curious if you guys are doing any projects with that or if there are any opportunities to bring in different technologies or try new things. Those are things that are going to show a lot of excitement and show a lot of energy about the job, which is something that your interviewer is going to be happy about rather than showing that you're disinterested. So that's number 2. And now the final thing that I would recommend, and this is something that I personally use all the time and love to keep in my back pocket because it means you never even have to really think about this. It's better, obviously, if you take the time to, you know, follow steps one and two to say, let me do a bit of research and come up with a question with some really targeted questions. But if you don't have time for that, or you're busy, or you're doing lots of different back-to-back interviews and you've already asked the questions that you had, the third thing you can do, and something that's really valuable, is ask opinion questions of your interviewer. Ask them about themselves, because people love to talk about themselves, and it's something that you can ask the same question to everyone. So a couple questions that I love to ask people were, what are your favorite things about the company, and what are your least favorite things about the company? Because that is a great opportunity to, one, you can learn a lot by asking people's opinions of this, and two, they're questions that everyone's going to have different answers. Everyone, it's going to give you that perspective, and they're going to be able to sort of think through it and talk through it. You can also ask them stuff about, like, what's your favorite project that you've worked on? What's something cool that you think most people don't know about the company? All these sorts of things that are really opinion questions. You still want to focus more on their relationship with the company rather than, like, you don't want to get into super personal questions. Like, what's your favorite vacation that you took? Because that's just not relevant. So keep it relevant. But if you ask these sort of personal opinion questions, you can use the same question over and over again and learn a lot about the company. So again, the three things that I would recommend that you do when you're asked these sorts of questions, which you are going to be if you go into an interview, is one, research the company and see if you can come up with questions that are going to be relevant to that company. Two, focus on questions that show interest and show excitement about the job and about the company and about your career in general. And three, ask opinion questions of the person so that you can ask the same question to multiple people, you can learn about the company, and you can make them happy because they get to talk about themselves. And so with that, that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed this, make sure that you go check out our free 50 coding interview questions guide at bytebybyte.com/50questions. We cover 50 of the most common coding interview questions. Really great guide. We've had tens of thousands of people download it, and we'd love to give that to you for absolutely free. I appreciate you joining me here, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.